plagued all of us. People think about growing in ruchnius and spiritual matters. People are frustrated with their failures. To deal a little bit with this problem tonight is something very interesting. There's a very interesting concept that Chazal teaches about growth. We spoke about it this Shabbat and Shiva. It wasn't explained. I'm going into a little bit more detail tonight. In Pirkei Avos it says, Shloisha Ksarim, there are three crowns that a person can attain and achieve, strive to achieve. Three crowns. Kingly crown. Kether is a crown, Shloisha Ksarim. Kether Torah is the crown of Torah. Kether Kahuna, there is the crown of Avodah being a Kohen in the Avodah in the service of the Beit HaMikdash, that Avodah. And Kether Malchus, there's a literal crown of royalty of being the king. So there are three crowns, Kether Torah, Kether Kahuna, and Kether Malchus. Torah is Jewish wisdom. Kahuna is a Avodah, servant to the Ribbono Shel Olam. Malchus, Jewish aristocracy, Jewish monarchy, who go into it in a while. So that's the mission. Shloshek Torah, and Kether Torah, Kether Kahuna, Kether Malchus. The Kether Shein Tov Oil Al Gabei. The Mishnah concludes that there's a crown which is called Kether Shein Tov, the crown of having a good name. This supersedes the first three aforementioned crowns. Kether Shein Tov, the crown of having a good name. We'll discuss in a moment what this means. Oil al Gabayim, this supersedes the first request. This is a Mishnah. This has to be studied to the best of our ability, to the best of our talent, and the Mishnah presents a number of difficulties. The morale, pride, he approaches this mission and he asks a number of fundamental questions. Number one, the Mishnah starts out to tell us, Shloishah Sarabim, there are three crowns. And the Mishnah enumerates, Kether Torah, Kether Kahuna, Kether Malchus. And then the Mishnah concludes, the Kether Shem Tov is Oil Al Gabayim. So there's four crowns. Why is there three crowns? Now, what does Kether Shem Tov mean? What do you think to have a good name? If they put your name in the National Herald, I mean, what does to have a good name? Simply to understand the Mishnah, we're learning the Mishnah for ourselves, to understand what does it mean to have a good name? Get the bottom line, right? What does it mean? The Rashi is concerned, in Pirkei Avos, this is what this means. The Rashi and the other Rishonim say, Kether Shem Tov means a person of Ma'asim Tovim, he does good deeds. Ma'asim Tovim. But a person that's committed and involved Marcus Poison's good deeds, his crime supersedes his profession. So the Maharal asks the question, how can that be? How can that be that this is the meaning of Kesa Shemra? You say there are three crimes, Kesa Torah, Kesa Kahuna, Kesa Mal. What is Kesa Torah? To know Torah, study Torah. Kesa Torah includes Kesa. There's no such thing in Torah. In Jewish thinking, there's no such thing as a person who possesses wisdom, scholarship, erudition, and doesn't live with it and doesn't practice it. The Gemara has the most reprehensive things to say about a person who knows and acts contrary. In Torah, there's no such thing. In Torah, there's no, a person's knowledge has no validity if it's not carried out into everyday living. So the Maharal says, according to Rashi, in the way the Bartanura learns, that Kesa Shemra, the crown of good names, means a person who doesn't identify it. So he says, what does that mean? And what does Kesa Torah mean? Kesa Torah means a person who learns the Torah, lives by Torah, shapes his life and his deeds through the direction that the Torah teaches him to do something. So what does it mean, Kesa Shemra? How can you come and tell me that Kesa Shemra means nice and pleasant good deeds? Good question. In Jewish thinking, there's no such thing as coming. Give you an example. I mean, a quite good example. The Gemara said in your Thomas that two other rabbis were sitting on a bench, and the third great Tom Coffin was coming by, so one of them began to get up to show the sign of respect. The other one was sitting there. What do you mean? If you get enough, you can't stop. He said, we should stand up for him. He's a Bama Kleshin. He's a person who's involved in dissension and making arguments between people. We can't show him any respect. It must be clear that a person who does not live by what he learns, a person who does not practice what he perceives, has no validity, has no standing. And so therefore, if you say that such a thing is called Keter Torah, then it's included. Keter Torah means he learns and he does not interpret it. And again, what's the problem? What's Keter Shemtai? What does Keter Shemtai mean? What does Rashi mean? We have to understand Rashi. What does he mean when he says Keter Shemtai means not interpret it? Today we're going into a subtle area tonight. Now, it's interesting in the Midrashim concerning these three crowns. These three crowns, the food for what is a crown, what's the meaning of a crown. It's beautiful to understand this. In the Mishkan this week, in the Sabbath that we study these weeks, it's about all the factors in the Mishkan. So the Magen says, there were vessels, there were tailors in the Mishkan, that had crowns around them. That little gate of crown around them. The Magen says, the Shulchan, which corresponds to Kesa Malchus, had a zayir, a crown around it. The table in the Mishkan was a table, and it had a little crown around it, a fringed crown out of gold around it. The shulchan, the table, corresponded to Malchus. The mizbeach had a crown on it. That corresponds to Kesa Kahuna. The orange had a crown around it from gold. That corresponds to Kesa Kahuna. Kesa Torah, Kesa Kahuna, Kesa Malchus, the Kalim and the Mishkan that correspond to these three crowns, each one of them had a crown. Kesa Shemtai, the Magus says, corresponds to the menorah. The menorah didn't have a crown. The menorah asks here too. If each one of these kesaras, each one of these
crown has corresponding kelim vessels in the Mishkan, which they also have crowns, our crown corresponding to the Ketashemtai, which superseded the priestly crown, didn't have a crown around. Okay. These are the questions. What does it mean, a crown? What does it mean a king wears a crown? What is the symbolism of a crown? What is it? There is an Ebenezer in Bamidbar. Beautiful, beautiful Ebenezer. We know in the title of the parsha that if a man says, I'm not going to drink wine for 30 days. He's a nausea. Nausea means that a person can take upon himself a certain room, a certain level of spiritual holiness. He can stay for 30 days, he can stay for a minimum of 30 days, but he's not allowed to drink wine, he's not allowed to cut his hair, he's not allowed to be in the camera later, he's not come in contact with dead people. He's like a miniature coin, a microcoin. So the Ebenezer starts to discuss etymologically the meaning and the root of the word nazir. Why do we call such a person a nazir? He says the word nazir has in it the word zayr, a crown. Ebenezer says, what does a nazir have to do with a crown? He says, society, the prevailing culture flows in a direction. And people are functioned up as our shapes, their attitudes and their outlook on the world and how they live is shaped by the prevailing culture. It is a man gets up and says, everybody drinks wine. Everybody goes to a cocktail party. Everybody's so strict. It's not a holy drink. The man gets up and says, I'm not going. His wife says, we're having a cocktail party. The socialites of the town are going to be, what do you mean you're not going? It's in the country club. He says, forget it, I'm not going. Why are you not going? I'm breaking away from this. This is not for me. This is not me. It's not what I want to be. It's not the direction that I want to go. I'm not going. The Ebenezer says this man becomes a ruler over a situation. He is not manipulated. He is not being shaped, but he becomes a shaper. He's a king. This experience of his separating himself from the prevailing culture is an act of royalty. He's called a nazir. It's as if he has a crown of himself. Crown is a line of a separation of delineation. Demarcation for separation. Everybody has this hat, he wears a crown like a fancy separation. That's the etymological root of the word nazir, as Nazir says this in quotes. These three crowns that the Mishnah introduces, he speaks about. The crown of Torah, the crown of Avodah, of Kohunah, and the crown of Melucha are results of human endeavor and human toil and human struggle and human frustration. Torah does not mean to sit and read the Gemara, or read the Chumash, or read the Tillim, or read the Nevi. It means the communion of placing myself under the flow of chokmah that comes out of it, of letting myself be shaped by it. It involves
an intense struggle. Because there are forces in human beings that say, what are you doing? Leave it alone. Don't leave it alone. What are you becoming? Christian? What are you doing? Where are you going? You'll be isolated. You'll be ostracized. People will look at you. The relationship of a person with Peter. This is a person allows himself to be exposed to the oil of Peter involves decision and rejection, acceptance and rejection. This involves conflict. So when the person attains the various grades, there are, who knows if there are, how many grades of Torah are on every rung of the ladder, it involves the struggle, the toil, the anguish, the drive of a person to attain it. The boy did the same thing. Kahuna involves kahuna, Kedusha. The Rambam says kahuna is not only limited to kahuna. Right, the Rambam's famous words, the Lord gave it Lady Guval. The Rambam says it's not only the tribe of Levi. El Kol Ha'Roi says a person wants to be Miskadosh B'Kedushasai. A person can take and so remove himself from the world and so purify himself and so elevate himself he can be like a Kohen. And Jewish monarchy, the Gemara says, David HaMelech said himself really Chalom. To be Malchus Beis David, he has to be totally selfless. To, you know what it means to erase itself? The Rambam brings down the lesson that Jewish Melech was, the Malchus was, Levi Leif Kol Yisrael, his self was, forget about him. In his heart beat the pulse of every Jewish heart. This is a result of the struggle. This is a result of accepting the rejection. It's a reformation practice. This concerns the first three sorrows. Ketzer Torah, Ketzer Kahuna, Ketzer Malchus is a result of a personal effort, a personal struggle, a personal commitment, personal frustration. There's an interesting thing that follows. There is a madrega which every person can have to a degree, to a proportion. Ketzer Shem Tov Masim Tovim, what does that mean? This is something which is already beyond personal struggle and personal strife. Let me explain to you what it means. What does that mean? Very interesting. Oh, the Gemara says in Kedusha, the Gemara says, Soifer Rosha La Tadik Ulevakish Lahamidah. Soifer Rosha. The Russia, the evil, the forces of evil, all the negative forces that there are in the universe. Gay and the Sabbath and all the forces of good. The forces of darkness are gazing on the forces of light in the universe. On the Vatishlam. The entire universe is positive and negative forces. The entire universe, from the most physical to the most spiritual, is a cover war of forces. So the Gemara says, Soifer Rosha La Tzadik U'Mevakesh La'Amidah. The forces of darkness are constantly on the alert. They want to vanquish and overpower the forces of light, of goodness, of the positive forces of the Torah. U'Mevakesh La'Amidah, and they want to kill it. They want to overpower it. So what? Who's stronger? The force of good or the force of evil? Honestly, it's defined in the Gemara. The Gemara says, "Il Moleh Hakadosh Baruch Hu Oyzroi Lo Yuchol."
The Gemara says, if the Rabbeinu Shel Olam didn't come to the aid of a human being in his conflict, in his striving, he would never overpower the forces of God. He would be lost, he would be vanquished, he would be conquered. There's such a thing in the life of individuals. Young people don't see it so clearly. But when a person advances in age and a person has a historical perspective on his own life, a person begins to see a mysterious hand in his throat. And that hand is called Ezer, the help of a Kodesh Baruch Hu. Siyata Deshmaya, the help of the religion. A person is weak. A person is an entity of conflicting and contradictory forces. A person has in his mind and his heart different voices. One voice says, be a Malach, and the other voice says, be a Galach. One voice tells him, listen, tell him to do what he likes. Let him hold you tight and shape your life. Do what you have to do. Use your own strength. You have certain unique strength. Use it positively, creatively. Go ahead, do it, do it. Someone says, ah, you're a slack. You're good. Then come bring to me, step to me. Says to me, the statistics of my life show me that I'm a failure. I said to him, do me a favor. Don't bring me such statistics. If I'll look at such a statistic of my life, I won't be seeing it. Forces of us. But there's a third force. There's a third chemical force, there's a ruchnistic chemical, which is called Siyata Deshmaya. This providential intervention of HaKadosh Baruch Hu in our life. You know, sometimes you get a compliment, you know, two compliments. I was riding today in a car with a young man. Fine. He says to me, Rabbi Nissim. He says to me, the miracle of my coming to Pai Rakam. He says, I shudder to think what would be with me. Marcelo, accomplished fellow, not a dumb man. He's a fellow who worked hard. But he noticed that above and beyond what he worked, there was an addition, there was an addendum. The revival pushed him. The right man is right. I'm not saying he is something special. For him, this was special. There is a force in a person's life in the struggle. In the struggle to live intelligently according to the Torah, in the struggle to see fire in this world, in the struggle to bring symmetry and toilet symmetry into our lives, in the struggle to the little serenity that we desire in our lives, what do we desire? What do we want? The little peace that we want that our lives should have. Balance, meaning, significance. In that struggle, there are a bunch of elements that need to help the person. That of intervention is excellent. Let me tell you what Kepler means and what Rashi means when he says. Rashi says that there's a fourth crown, which is called the crown of Shemsai of the good name. Rashi says, what does a good man mean, good deeds? He's not talking that there are two types of good deeds. There are two types of good deeds. There are good deeds that we are commanded to do. The Torah says that a person has to be a Shomer Shabbos, to keep Shabbos. This is something that the Torah is incumbent upon every Jew to keep Shabbos. The Torah commanded us to do this good deed. The Torah says, yes. So it says a woman is making a challah, she has to take challah. That goes without saying, these good deeds, this whole spectrum of good deeds, the 613 mitzvahs, all go under the heading of prayer. There are another set of good deeds. There are a set of good deeds which begin to emerge after a person achieves a certain amount of victory in their life. It's what's sort of matter. What's sort of matter? It's almost on the way. Nothing is on imagine in life, but in comparison, under distinction, it's on the way. A person struggles with something, and then he acquires it. After the acquisition, I'll give you examples, but after the acquisition, it almost functions mechanically. I've reached that rung of the ladder already. I've acquired that, it's natural. It's part of me. It has become internalized. It's part of me. That's the way I function. I remember speaking to a man. A man comes into me. I once told you a story as he speaks. A man comes into me. His wife is very religious. And I met with him. Young man, what a looking man. He said, "He's crying, dude. My wife is religious. I love religion, I love the Shabbat. My business," he says, "I'm in the beginning of the growth of my business, it's just growing. My business is just growing. Saturday is a very important day. How can you expect me to give up my career? I have no other career." He says, "I'm just in the beginning of Shabbat. It's crying, it's just crying." What are you going to tell him? Tell him, away your business, I can help. This spoke to Morales and said, "Come, listen here. You ever go away for a weekend?" "Sure. Really?" "I said, why don't you go home for a weekend? What's the 4 weeks instead of going away to Lake Tahoe?" "Tahoe, instead of going there, go home and keep a Shabbat once a 4 weeks. Can you do that? Go home and keep a Shabbat, you'll be a full Shabbat." "Yeah, I could do that." "I said, do that." Make a long story short, he went home, kept a Shabbat, 4 weeks later, kept another Shabbat, another Shabbat, another Shabbat. He was strong. He became a full Shabbat. He began to see that this can survive. It's possible. All the shadows that he saw around his business if he keeps Shabbat, it's what fantasy. It was an illusion. You can keep Shabbat. Yeah, you've got to work out things, it's a little bit difficult, it's a little tiring, you have to prepare, you have to make up some bit, but you're not supposed to be shy. What happened? In the evolution of the shy, in the beginning, he had to struggle for it. It was something that he did. 3 years later, when he kept Shabbat, it was to him, you know, that already, as far as Shabbat was, he already was. Damn, he's a shoulder Shabbat. He had the good name of being a Shomer Shabbos. It was already part of him. This was his path. This was a role that he sat on already. He had achieved it. There are three Shloshik Tzoronim, there are three crowns.
It's the name of that gift is an expansion of a person's dimension, of a person's worldview, of a person's sensitivities. That's called Kefeshem Tegmatim Tayyip. There are deeds already that are beyond you. You have gone through the reformation. You know, there are people, it's difficult in a way. You know, there are people, you tell them, boy comes into the yeshiva, I tell him, "Listen here, young boy." I said to him, "He's a nice boy." I said to him, "Could you know these six lines Thursday by Sunday? Can you come back and tell me these six lines by heart?" "Oh, I can't do that. I can't do it. Don't ask me, I can't do it. Do me a personal favor, try another six lines by Sunday." He comes in Sunday, he knows four lines. I say, "Okay, by Tuesday, now you know four. If you have another two lines, no, by Tuesday, teach them. Know the four lines of the heart." Tuesday comes in, you know six lines of the heart? tell him we're going to do the whole page. You're going to know the whole Dachbar. He says, I can't, please, I can't, don't, I can't do it. I didn't tell you, I'm not going to punish you. I'm not going to... Just work another 2 months. Just a whole page. How can I do a whole page for her? He was never trained to learn to study. He only saw whole pages in front of him. He didn't know. No one took the trouble to teach him that a whole page is mastered by knowing one line. There are people that don't open up the safe. Men and women, the people that their minds are stale. Woe is to the person, woe is to the man, to the woman, that their minds are stale, that they never see a new idea. We were at a wedding last night, big wedding. And I met many of my friends. Everybody with beers, you know, with the whole get up. Everybody was there. And I look around. Some of my friends come over to me. You were here, I think I saw. The phrase, show what you want is beautiful, I saw. Yeah. Other guy can do this. I just answer a question. You want to hear some? Other people. Hi, you. No. You can tell a person if he's staying. Can he stack me? To reach the report. You tell a person to learn the biggest, the greatest thing in the world. They can't, but a person does. So the first period of time when a person is struggling to learn and to make themselves a schedule and to learn something every day, not much. That person is involved in the battle of Kesetra. That person is involved in the conflict of my learning something, of my mastering. After you have mastered it, you already achieved the Kesetra, then it's yours. If it's internalized, if you've done it, if the experience chopped out a road in your life to see you can do it, that's Kesetra. And the Tanna says an amazing thing. The rubber was important. The first 3 crowns were important. The fourth crown is not included in it. The fourth crown is when you're in orbit. The goal is to achieve and to move on. Once you have achieved, that's Kesef Shalom. Where a person and his deeds and his master, playing what Rashi means, where a person and his deeds and master, I have become the better person. I do this master playing because I am this. There's a subtle point, I don't know if I'm making myself clear. There's a point when you break through the gravity barrier, where you can float. The person struggles together with the Siyat, the Shmaya that gets the Rebbe Shlom, brings him to a Madrega, that these Masses Toivim is Shemta. What does Shemta mean? A person's name, this person's name, this Rav, a layer. Where I become identified with the deeds that I'm doing, it's just like my name would be, my name is Shlomo, someone says these, this is his name, this is what he is, this is the substance of the person, this is already beyond the strong. And everybody can do it in their life. You talk to a person, I look at people. To learn is, without learning, without the Kesetra, I look at people amazed. I look at people that wait for me. That go from day after day, week after week. A year goes by, and another sit down and honestly look in the mirror and say to themselves, what did I learn this week? What did I expose myself to this week? You can't come to the, without the Kesetra, you can't come to the Kesetra. You can't come to a new identity. You know, I have experienced that sometimes a person that I went to grade school has been calling me the last few years. Called me by my nickname that they used to call me in grade school. And he's a favor. He's in difficult straits and he's looking for people to help him. And he talks to me on the phone. Friendly! He talks to me as if we were exactly going to 7th grade. At the beginning, it sounded weird. It's quite a few years since I'm not great. And it's talking to me as if we're in the 7th grade, and I could not define it. I could not define it to myself. And I understood what it was. He's still here. He's ungrateful, not because he's not really incompetent. His horizons are the same. His mind is totally stable. Yeah, he's married, he has a family, he has a job, he has a problem, but he's still in grade school. He's still in grade school. He's still... He has had no exposure to anyone. He has no shento. He has not identified himself in life. He has not identified himself with any rung on the ladder where you can say that this has become part of his substance. He was being grateful. Very difficult to speak to him. Kesa shentoi toila agabei means a person can grow. A person can change. A person can get a new identity. He can get a new shento that the mas and toivim, that the things that he is involved with are not extrinsic but are intrinsic. They are intrinsically him, isn't it? Every keli in the Mishkan had a crown around it. The crown of separation, the crown that symbolized the struggle. Shento is connected to Minerva. It's just life. It's a different life. The person sees things differently. He's a different person. And doesn't need a crown. There's no more struggle. Young women get married and have to learn how to cook. It's the worst thing in the world sometimes. But once you master it, you know, of course it's a toil. Of course it requires concentration. But it's already me. The recipe in myself, I know it. I have the confidence. I identify with it. I can do it leisurely almost. The same thing you're looking for spiritually. The Tana of the Mishnah says there are three struggles in a person's life. But after the struggle, there is a change, a metamorphosis in the person, where he becomes a different. That's a crown that you receive without a crown, without the symbol of a struggle. So our failures and our setbacks don't mean anything. The struggle is important. And somehow afterwards, if you do it, you're a different person. You're a different person. You have to look and you have to see. Talking with Shiva, certain people, you look at them, you see that the complexion changed. It's not my imagination. After a while, you see that the substance of their being changed. Keseshentai means after the struggle. What results after the reformation, after the refinement process, happens in every person's life. In various degrees. It's the struggle that's important, the setbacks are not important, the failures and the disappointments are not important. It's the continuing struggle till the person is suddenly and mysteriously person identifies yourself with a different sensitivity, with a different hashkafa, with a different outlook. Without Kesaperia can't have this. I'm amazed, you know, we have so much abilities to learn nowadays, men, women. One sentence a day. Exposure to this can expand a person's dimensions.